गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल, सिट इन सुखासन। हैंड्स रेस्टिंग ऑन द नीज इन ज्ञान मुद्रा और चिन मुद्रा। सिट एरेक्ट, क्लोज योर आईज, स्टार्ट प्रेयर। गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देव महेश्वरः, गुरु साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। ओम शांति शांति शांति। हरिः ओम तत्सत्। ॐ नमः। स्लोली डीप ब्रीथ, इनहेल एक्सहेल। स्लोली डीप ब्रीथ, इनहेल एक्सहेल। रिलैक्स, ओपन योर आईज।
Now we start leg movements. Leg movements help us reduce knee pains and help strengthening muscles. Dandasana. Technique. Take a footstep gap between two legs. Bring your both hands to your back to support your body. This posture helps you to relax. Now we start ankle bending movement. Exhale, bend your feet slowly downwards, both the feet. Inhale, bend your feet slowly upwards. Now we repeat this for 3 times. Exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, relax. Now we switch on to the next movement. It is ankle rotating movement. First, bend your feet downwards and start rotating. Bend your feet downwards and start rotating them in clockwise direction for 4 times. Rotate them in clockwise direction for 4 times. Now, upwards. Bend your feet upwards and rotate them in anti-clockwise direction for 4 times. Now in anti-clockwise direction for 4 times. Relax. come to Dandasana. Slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Samasthiti. Join your both legs together. Samasthiti. Join your both legs together. Now let's move on to the next one. Knee bending movement. Exhale. Bring your right leg close to your chest. Inhale. Straighten your leg without touching ground. Now we repeat this for 3 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Relax. Now we do the same to the left leg for 3 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Relax. Dandasana. Slowly breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Samasthiti. Now we move on to butterfly movement. The next movement is butterfly movement. Dandasana. Slowly breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. Come to Samasthiti. Join both legs together. Now, bend the knees and bring both feet close to your pelvis with your hands. I repeat, bend the knees and bring both feet close to your pelvis with your hands. Now, exhale. Bring both your knees upwards as much as you can. Inhale. Bring both your knees downwards, touching the ground. Now repeat this for 10 times. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Exhale. Inhale. Relax. Now stretch out your legs slowly. Slowly breathe in. Breathe out. Dandasana. Slowly breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Now we switch over to spinal movements. Spinal movements help us in many ways. This movement massages abdominal organs. It melts cholesterol in the stomach. It helps in weight loss. It also helps and increase body flexibility. The first one is boat rowing, Dandasana. Stretch your legs out and join them. Stretch your hands out forward to your shoulder level and fold your fingers. Now exhale. Bring your upper body forward. Inhale. Bring your upper body backward. Do it like rowing a boat. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. It should be like rowing a boat. Exhale. Inhale. When you come forward, it is exhale. When you go backwards, it's inhale. Do the same in anticlockwise. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Relax. Dandasana. Now slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now we move on to the next movement, Chakki Chalan, Samasthiti. Bring your both legs together. Now leave 3 feet gap between your legs. Leave 3 feet gap between your legs. Bring both your hands out and interlock both the palms. Now, inhale, rotate your hands in a clockwise direction, bending your body backwards to the halfway. Exhale. Rotate your hands to complete the rotation, bending your body forward. Now do it for 3 times. Inhale. Exhale. Don't bend your legs and touch your toes while rotating. Remember, you should not bend your legs, and while rotating, you should touch your toes. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Now do it in anticlockwise. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Relax. Dandasana. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Now we move on to the next one, spinal twisting movement. The next one is spinal twisting movement, Samasthiti. Join your both legs together. Now leave 3 feet gap between your legs. Leave 3 feet gap between your legs. Stretch your hands sideways to your shoulder level. Now, exhale, turn your body to your right side, touching your right toes. Inhale, come to normal position. Exhale, turn your body to the left side, touching your left palm. Inhale, come to the normal position. Now repeat this for 3 times. Exhale, turn right side, touch your toes. Inhale, come to normal position. Exhale, turn left side, touch your palms. Inhale, come to normal position. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Relax. Dandasana. Slowly inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Samasthiti. Sit in Sukhasana.
Let us move on to the next posture. Uttana Padasana. It's also called raised leg posture. Let us see the benefits of this raised leg posture. It reduces the fat in the areas of hips, thighs and torso. It cures all the diseases pertaining to urinary system, piles and fistula. Let us see the technique of this asana. Lie flat on the back on a soft blanket, keeping the leg stretched. Place both the hands by the side of the trunk, palms touching the ground. Take a few deep breaths. While inhaling, raise the left leg without bending the knee, pointing the toes up to an angle of 45 degrees. For a few seconds, be in the same posture and bring it down with exhalation. While inhaling, raise the right leg without bending at the knee, pointing the toes up to an angle of 45 degrees. For a few seconds, be in the same posture and bring it down with exhalation. Repeat the same movement with the right leg and the left leg. Repeat both the legs together. Raise your both legs. And bring them down with exhalation. And relax. Let us move on to the next one, Savasana. It is also called Cobb's posture. Let's see the benefits of this Cobb's posture. This removes the fatigue caused by the other asanas and induces calmness of the mind. It is a relaxation posture. Now let's see the technique of this Savasana. Lie flat on the back like a corpse. Keep the hands a little away from the thighs with the palms up. Place the feet apart such that both the heels face inwards and toes outwards. Face the feet apart. Such that both the heels face inward and toes outward. Relax the body completely, part by part, with awareness of the breath and closed eyes. Be in that posture for some time and relax. Thank you. and after some time come back to samasthiti and relax. Let us go for the next one, Salabhasan. It is also called locust posture. Let us see the benefits of this locust posture. This posture relieves pain in the knees and hips. It cures constipation. Lie full length on the floor on the stomach with the chin touching the ground on soft blanket. Keep the hands by the side of the trunk such that the palms touch the ground. Raise the left leg with inhalation and do not bend the knees, stretch the toes. For a few seconds, be in the same posture and bring it down with exhalation. When you raise the right leg with inhalation without bending at the knee, stretching the toes, and after a few seconds, please bring it down with exhalation.
Surya Namaskar or Sun Salutation is a sequence of 12 powerful yoga poses. Please stand up. Step 1, Pranamasana. Step 2, Hasta Uttasana. Step 3, Pada Hastasana. Step 4, Ashva Sanchalanasana. Step 5, Dandasana. Step 6, Ashtanga Namaskara. Step 7, Bhujangasana. Step 8, Parvatasana. Step 9, Ashva Sanchalanasana. Step 10, Pada Hastasana. Step 11, Hasta Uttasana. Pranamasana. Relax. Raise your hands up. Bring your hands down. Now, let us repeat all the steps one more time. Step 1, Pranamasana. Step 2, Hasta Uttasana. Step 3, Pada Hastasana. Step 4, Ashva Sanchalanasana. Step 5, Dandasana. Step 6, Ashtanga Namaskara. Step 7, Bhujangasana. Step 8, Parvatasana. స్టెప్ 9 అశ్వసంచలనాసనం. స్టెప్ 10 పాదహస్తాసనం. స్టెప్ 11 హస్త ఉత్తాసనం. స్టెప్ 12 ప్రణామాసనం. Now relax, raise your hands up, slowly bring them down. Now slowly breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Now let us repeat all the steps one by one. Step 1, pranamasana. Step 2, hasta uttasana. Step 3, పాదహస్తాసనం. స్టెప్ 4, అశ్వసంచలనాసనం. స్టెప్ 5, దండాసనం. స్టెప్ 6, అష్టాంగ నమస్కారం. స్టెప్ 7, భుజంగాసనం. Step 8, Parvatasana. Step 9, Ashwasanchalanasana. Step 10, Padahastasana. Step 11, Hastavuttasana. Step 12, Pranamasana. Now relax, raise your hands up, slowly bring them down, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Now Savasana. Now slowly lie down on your back. Leave some space between both the legs. Stretch your hands a little. Now slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale. Exhale. Now Samasthiti. Bring your both legs together, hands together. Slowly get up and sit. Now let us see the meaning of Surya Bhedana. In yogic terminology, the right nostril referred to the gateway of sun energy or Pingala Nadi. And left nostril is gateway of moon energy or Ida Nadi. Sun energy is the representation of heart or masculine vitality in the body, while moon energy represents calmness or feminine vitality. If we go by the literal meaning of Surya Bhedana, Surya means sun, Bhedana means piercing or entering. Surya Bhedana Pranayama is the deep inhalation of breath through the right nostril, then holding the breath for as long as comfortable, and finally exhaling through the left nostril. Now sit in any comfortable position, but sit erect. Form Prana Mudra with your right hand. When you close your right nostril, use your right thumb. When you close your left nostril, use your right finger, ring finger, and little finger. Is the deep inhalation of breath through the right nostril, then holding the breath for as long as comfortable, and finally exhaling through the left nostril. Let us do it. Inhale through right nostril, hold it for some time, exhale it through left nostril. Now repeat this. Inhale through right nostril, hold it for some time, exhale through left nostril. Inhale, exhale, hold, exhale, inhale, inhale, hold, exhale, inhale, hold, exhale. Inhale, hold, exhale. Inhale, hold, exhale. Relax. Kapala Bhati is also known as skull shining breath. Kapala means skull and Bhati means light. The emphasis is on the exhalation through strong, fast abdominal contractions, and so has a cleansing effect on the breathing pathways. Now let us see the benefits of this Kapala Bhati. It improves circulation, especially to the brain, which gives the skull shining effect, energizing the mind and waking up your system. Kapalabhati also creates heat and increases and stimulates the digestive fire, which is also called Agni, by strengthening, massaging and toning the abdominal muscles and digestive system. Let us see the Kapalabhati technique. The inhale follows naturally after the strong exhale.
relax. Now slowly inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Now let us repeat this Kapalabhati one more time. The inhale follows naturally after the strong exhale. Relax. Slowly inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale.
Pranayamas. The term pranayama consists of the words prana and ayama, meaning pranic energy and its expansion. Pranayama means to expand pranic energy and keep it under control. Breath is the sign of prana in the body. By a proper manipulation of the breath, prana can be expanded and controlled. It has direct link with the mind and the movement of the eyeball. So, while doing pranayama, attention must be paid to stoppage of the movement of the eyeball and thus gaining concentration. Let us move on to the next one, Bhramari Pranayama. It is also known as humming bee breath. Let us see the benefits of this posture. Bhramari relieves stress and cerebral tension. It also helps elevating anger, anxiety, and insomnia. Now, sit in a comfortable meditation asana. Close the eyes and relax the whole body for a short time. Put your index fingers in both of your ears and start listening to the humming sound within your body. The humming sound should be smooth, even, and continuous for the duration of the exhalation.
Relax. Prayer. Namaskar Mudra. Swasti bhavatu. Om sarvesham shanti bhavatu. Om sarvesham purnam bhavatu. Om shanti shanti shanti. Hari Om tas. Om namah. అందరికీ నమస్కారం.